Hello children, take your history book. We will read the second lesson, chapter 2 in history. Okay, from hunting to hunting, gathering to growing food. Tushar's train journey. Tushar was going from Delhi to Chennai for his cousin's wedding. They were traveling by train and he had managed to squeeze into the window seat. His nose glued to the glass pane. As he watched trees and houses fly past, his uncle tapped his shoulder and said, "Do you know, the trains were first used about 150 years ago and that people began using buses a few decades later." Tushar wondered, when people couldn't travel quickly from one place to another, did they spend their entire lives wherever they were born? Not quite. So, from now we are moving very, not at all quickly, but we are moving. But instead of in ancient days, how they have moved? The Tushar doubt. Let's read this. The earliest people, why were they on the move? We know about people who lived in the subcontinent as early as 2 million years ago. How many years ago? 2 million years ago. Today we describe them as hunter-gatherers. Those people, how we are calling hunter-gatherers. The name comes from the way in which they got their food. Generally, they hunted wild animals, caught fish and birds, gathered fruits, roots, nuts, seeds, leaves, stalks and eggs. Hunter-gatherers moved from place to place. There are many reasons for this. First, if they had stayed at one place for a long time, they would have eaten up all the available plant and animal resources. So, in ancient days, they have eaten raw animal also. In ancient days, they have eaten lot of animal resources only. They hunt whatever they hunted the animal, they have eaten as raw. They don't have to cook also. Just they will have eaten by raw. Therefore, they would have had to go elsewhere in search of food. Second, animals move from one place to place either in search of smaller prey or in the case of deer and wild cattle, in search of grass and leaves. That's why those who hunted them had to follow their movements. So how they are getting know this? However, they hunted by their movements only. Third, plants and trees bear fruit in different seasons. So, people may have moved from season to season in search of different kinds of plants. Yeah, those people called as tribes. They should not be stayed at same places. They will move. The fourth stage, the people, plants and animals need water to survive. Water is found in lakes, streams and rivers. While many rivers and lakes are perennial, it means throughout the year, Vatrada Nadigal, perennial means. Others are seasonal. People living on their banks would have had to go in search of water during the dry seasons, winter and summer. For example, the perennial river throughout the year, which goes perennial, like perennial, Sindhu, Satluj, and Ganga, Yamuna, those rivers and all, the perennial rivers example. For the non-perennial river example are our Kaveri, Godavari, Tamrabarani, those rivers and all, etc. How do we know about these people? Archaeologists only. Who is the thing we have to know about our earliest, current people, those things and all, we can know by archaeologists. Archaeologists have found some of the things hunter-gatherers made and used. It's likely that people made and used tools of stone, wood and bone, of which stone tools have survived best. So they will make the things, everything by themselves only. Some of these stone tools were used to cut meat and bone, scrap bark. Bark, scrap bark means from the trees only they get, and hides, animal skin, chopped fruit and roots. Some may have been attached to handles of bone or wood to make spears and arrows for hunting. Spears, the spears to be look like a triangle shape, at the same time it's we have a handle. This is spears. Okay, like look like an arrow. Other tools were used to chop wood, which was used as firewood. Wood was also used to make hut and tools. Yeah, they can make a hut also by using wood. Stone tools may also have been used for digging the ground to collect edible roots. For the left side pick, this is the left side, digging the ground, how they are digging the ground. Okay, stitching cloths made out of animal skin, they are stitching here, see. So that purpose also they can made and by skin, sorry, stones only. Then choosing a place to live in, this is the map to below. Okay, all the places marked with red triangles are sites from which archaeologists have found evidence of hunter-gatherers. Hunter-gatherers lived in many more places. Only some are shown on the map. Many sites were located near sources of water such as rivers and lakes. See here, each and everything has to be some different things, sites. Okay, the triangle that is called a palethic. Earlier we can get the things often. Continuously we are making the research. Then Neolithic. Neolithic sites means it's to be rare area. Megalithic, we can get a lot and lot. Early village, ரொம்பவே சீக்கிரமாக உருவாக்கப்பட்ட கிராமங்கள். Modern cities. Modern cities. Nowadays, what are the things? Modern. So get a map. You have to mark these places, get the practice, because of these and all archaeological sites. In our Tamil Nadu, what are the things very especially important? Brahmagiri, Adichanallur. Okay, those things and all very very important in Tamil Nadu. Then Payyambali. Okay, turn the next page. We will continue to read. Bimbetka, in present day it is in Madhya Pradesh. This is an old site with caves and rock shelters. People choose these natural caves because they provided shelter from the rain, heat and wind. These rock shelters are close to the Narmada Valley. Can you think of why people choose to live here? Yeah, near to valley or else mountains, it is the best way to get roots and some water, hunting animals or for anything. We can get the things from easily to those area. But it's to be look like a case. We can draw lot of paintings in at the rocks. As stone tools were important, people tried to find places where good quality stone was easily available. So see this rock painting. A painting from a rock shelter. This is called a rock paintings. Many of the caves in which these early people lived have paintings on the walls. Some of the best examples are from Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. So we can get the rock paintings, everything where? Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. These paintings show wild animals drawn with great accuracy and skill. See, this is a painting. Then sites. Or places where the remains of things, tools, pots, buildings, etc. were found. These were made, used and left behind by people. These may be found on the surface of the earth, buried under the earth, or sometimes even under water. You will learn more about different sites in later chapters.